if you've been here for a while now, you know that we overcame a couple of frustrations about our frames when we found out that a lot of them were rotten and that a lot of them would need to be replaced. Then we actually decided to replace all of them because that was the right thing to do. Then we were replacing them and the wood was not arriving to us because we had so much rain and floods that the trucks couldn't come here with all the wood. And after all the things that happened, we are now finally installing the last frames on our boat. So this is a huge milestone and we are beyond happy.
Hi, I'm Ben.
And I'm MP. We love the ocean, so we decided to make it our home by buying a massive wooden schooner, which is unfortunately sinking.
A lot of people believe our boat is doomed, but we refuse to settle on that thought, and we are willing to do whatever it takes to bring it back to its former glory.
Join us on this refurbishing journey and wish us luck.
Today is an exceptionally good day because finally the wood arrived to finish our last six frames, which we've been waiting for two, maybe even more weeks. So all the other wood we've got here just couldn't be put onto the boat until the last frames were done, because this top plank has been fixed up to where the gray starts again. And before we can do more planking, this top one has to be made to hold all the frames together. So now we can finish these aft frames, because then we can finish this top plank. And it's another hot day and I'm gonna suffer. It's humid, it's been raining, flooding for like a week now as well. But the boat's looking amazing. Luckily we don't have any caulking in the boat yet, so all the water just drips straight out. So that's very cool. So just to show you, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 frames that still need to be made. And we have 7 and 8 that are almost ready. So out of those two big planks, we're really hoping to get those 6. If not, we're not gonna cut it short. But yeah, very cool. Very happy. Sometimes the saw isn't always ready. We've got Seca over here cutting it. We can do it fast, but it's not. What do you do when you wait for the saw to be sharpened? This is the carpenter's doodling. You just go over the lines many times. At least now I can show you how the drawing looks like from far, because normally you can't see it, but it's gone over I think 3 times now waiting for this saw to be cut. Beautiful. Zeca, quantos dentes? So the reason this takes long is it has 800 teeth and this has to be done after every 5 or 6 frames or so. I was asking him why it was going so slowly. Not anymore.
Já lhe falei, seja a hora. Seja a hora, seu malvado.
É, dá pra passar lá, pra lá, só pra soltar aí em cima, não, passa pra cá, é delícia.
Não, nem passar. Não é mais nada, Nico.
Tá bom, não estava muito.
Agiliza bem, malandra corrente.
having a little look around in this engine room as we're almost finishing closing it with frames. You might notice that half of this floor timber has gone, and this one over here is also snapped off. So we might have mentioned it before, but the frames and the floor timbers that are under the sea level where we had salt water infiltration are actually quite preserved, which is why we're keeping them. However, the ones that were here and this one cracked because of being in contact with iron. So there was an iron plate here to hold the prop shaft. It had caused that rusted and caused the wood or the floor timber to crack. And here it's probably cracked because of the huge screws they use, actually pegs, nails they used on this boat, that caused the stress inside the wood to be too high and crack. And also just looking over here, where did I see it? So they did use some screws to put through the planks onto the frames, and as you can see even here they missed it. As it was under a tank, we didn't notice it before, but let's go and have a look at the pieces that just got removed. This is the entire floor timber that got removed. Have a look here. There was a big iron plate on here that was causing this to actually, it's not that bad. Well, actually here, that's what happens with it. So the wood gets weak, and when stress gets put on it, it cracks. Same over here, the big iron pegs were through here and here, this crack. Because also these two pegs were put in the same grain of this plank, which should never be done, because if this one started cracking a little bit like so, it would have automatically gone to the second one. If they'd put one here, for example, and one a lot lower down, it might have avoided this situation. So this other part of the floor timber, also not good. This actually rot. It might have been because it had the tree sap inside here because it was still underwater. But yeah, these are gonna be fixed and replaced. We have been ignoring this for a very long time, but it's getting in the way, so I think it's time to get rid of this. Also, the next floor timber to go is this one. I wonder why. Can't believe it made it here. Anyway, we're gonna find out where that wire goes. So it's actually just all the sockets for the table here. So I'm gonna cut them as close to the edges here as possible and send it down. Blimey, that's all that gone. It's hot everywhere here. As it's been raining, and now it's just super, super hot and sunny. So all the water just damps up. Everything is just so hot. Look at that compared to before. Why is not hanging through the middle anymore? That's epic. So when Zeka is not on the machine sharpening the teeth, he is here with this tool. I don't know if you can see, actually cutting the teeth individually to make them sharp again. Now that's determination. So together with the other frames, you can see here, not so strong. These are actually three floor timbers attached to each other. This one cracked here, cracked over there where the nails went in. This one also cracked, obviously, over here. So that area was probably a very weak spot of the boat, which is why three of the floor timbers, even frame, cracked. So we're gonna make sure that's strong when we rebuild it. So now all he has to do is measure to see how big it's allowed to be to fit in his toolbox. Makes a line. And that's how big the hammer can be.
I'm here to answer a question that we are getting a lot. I'm gonna call this session of the video, I learned it from Google, right? So the question is, why are we not using red lead to cover our wood? What is red lead to start with? Red lead is a primer that's an anti-corrosion and rust-proof primer made out of lead oxide. So that's why it's a bit orange, because it's like the rust of the lead, the oxide. Yeah? Let's keep going. The thing is, the red lead is made out of lead and chromium together, and that's a very toxic combination. I'm scared I'm gonna fall. The original red lead is made of a combination of lead and chromium, and now we know that that combination is very toxic and very dangerous for our health. So now the new red lead that we can actually find in the market is a synthetic lead that's not made with those two ingredients that can be dangerous. And because it doesn't need to be made of the lead oxide anymore, it doesn't have that orange tone that was natural from the ingredients before. So it can be done in any color. In the market, we can still find the orange, because it's like the trademark of the lead is the orange reddish tone. But they also created the gray one because it's a more neutral color that's easier to cover up later. Because of that reason, we chose the gray one because it's easier to paint on top later and it doesn't have the tone. But it still has the same qualities. It's also rust-proof and anti-corrosion. It's just as good, it's just as efficient, but it's not dangerous to our health. So this is what we're using here, and I hope now you understand as much as we do.
here are the two pieces that make the one floor timber in place. They aren't finished yet because this piece is longer than this piece and has to be planed and sanded down still. There's still a little gap over there. But once this is finished, there's going to be a little piece of floor timber like this, but smaller. Just connecting these two with four bars.
I want to explain about the sentado, which is the shear wood?
Shear plank.
Shear plank. And you see that they are not really aligned. This one is finishing there and the next one's finishing there. Why is that? Is that a mistake? No. Here I have a perfect brick wall to explain exactly what we're doing with the shear plank. If all the bricks were aligned on top of each other, the wall wouldn't be strong. That's why brick walls are done like this, and that's exactly what we are doing there. If the planks of the shear plank were perfectly aligned, we'll always have a middle piece that will be fragile. And this way, we have 5 centimeters thick plank and another on top of 4 centimeters, so we won't have any place that will be fragile. They will be all very solid and strong. And that's very important because the shear plank is the one that holds the shape of the boat. It holds all the frames together. So yeah, that's what's happening here. Ben.
What is it?
What do you have to say about the last frames being installed?
I think it's just so cool that it's finally happening after the week we had. So it was a really, really, really bad week with no wood and a lot of rain and stuff just went so slow. Now we have a lot of wood and no rain. So we have like 2 or 3 more frames to finish. We're busy putting some floor timbers in at the moment. Then done, start planking with all the new planks we've just received.
Victory high five. Nice. Opinion, today the worms are the tastiest thing in the whole universe. So if you guys would like to try to season your food with it, you can come here because we have plenty and we are willing to donate it.
So I'm here at the stern of the boat. Actually, I'm standing exactly where the transom should come later. What still has to be done for it to float? Well, art, but we need to still put one floor timber over here exactly where this frame is finishing, because we are adding this one on top of the ones that were already here when we bought the boat. There was actually no frame going between this last one against the transom and this one. So we're gonna add one, because I don't know if you can tell, the spacing between these two is quite big, so it just makes sense to have one here if we have the space anyway.
So guys, it started to rain, and when it rains work gets a bit slow and it's not the same, so I think this is a wrap. What happened today? Frames. We finished all the frames of the boat. I just cannot really celebrate because one, the shape itself is ready and it's there, but it's still not bolted in place. So it's almost all finished, which is really, really exciting because I remember the day that I thought, oh, I can't believe we need to change so many frames, and now it's done and I look at the boat and I'm so proud of the decision we took and I'm so happy on how it's looking. So this is actually great news. So we still had a couple of rotten frames that were there for structure and shape, and now they're all gone, so no rotten frames anymore, and all frames are new, except that this last one still needs to be bolted, but otherwise it's a brand new, not whole yet, but well, how do you call the group of frames? It's a whole new group of frames. And I'm under the rain to show you this. I'm not enjoying it so much, so bye.
Before we head out, MP and I would like to say something small and big, which is
thank you.
Thank you so much to everyone who's helped us out through PayPal and Patreon, also sending us messages, lifting up our spirit, and also the support and the info we've gotten from everyone. It's amazing.
Yeah, thank you so much to everyone. And we are very happy with the Patreon platform because it gives us a chance to give something back to the people who are supporting us. That's why we put so much heart in everything we offer there, like weekly summaries of everything that happened, also the real-time updates that we post, so only patrons really know how the boat's looking today. And
like this.
That's like the biggest sneak peek ever.
I don't know how if they can see it. Anyway.
Yeah, anyway, so thank you so much everyone that's on Patreon, and we really, really hope that you enjoy the things that we offer. We really put a lot of effort and heart on it, so we hope you are happy because we are really happy.
And if you're someone who sent us emails to help us out or even just stay in touch with us, thank you.
Tips and motivation.
If you're someone who comments frequently, thank you for that.
Yeah.
If you've even liked this video, like this video right now, so we will like you even more, and subscribe and we'll love you.
So this is just to say thank you to everyone that's helping us and being with us, supporting us, and just living this dream with us.
See you around and stay tuned because we've got a lot coming.
See you next Sunday.